60 plus people on Informatica Power Center.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, all right, great. So before I get started, I would like to understand whether you have already...
Your voice is breaking.
Hello?
Hello? Yeah.
Hello?
Hello?
Is it fine? Yeah, is it fine now?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So, I'd like to understand whether you are trying to do data warehousing or BI at all. Somebody who has already worked in, BI, something they would already know all these concepts, but you know, it will be a good refresher if you want to again go through this. So what we'll be talking about in the first week is we'll talk about what data warehouse is, why do we need a data warehouse. We'll talk about RDBMS. When I talk about RDBMS, we'll talk about what a table is, what a column is, how do you join two tables, inner join, outer join, left outer join, all this stuff. After that, we'll talk about normalization and how different normalization and denormalization are. What do we use in data warehousing, whether we use normalized tables, denormalized tables. Why do we use denormalized tables, and all these things we'll be talking about. After that, we'll talk about what is a dimension, what is a fact, what are the different types of dimensions available, what are the different types of facts available. We'll also have to understand Snowflake schema and star schema in detail. So the first week, the first 5 days will go pretty slow, where we'll try to understand all the theoretical concepts related to warehousing, which would help you on a job floor when you are working on Informatica Power Center tool, because Informatica Power Center tool is all about creating a warehouse from your ERP systems. So the first week we'll lay the foundation to understand what a warehouse is, what are the different concepts we need to understand so that you can work on an Informatica Power Center tool. So this is going to be a theoretical session for the first 1 week. I go very slow in the first 1 week so that people get their installation done on the system. At the same time, if there are any more folks joining in the course, we'll try to accommodate them. So this is how the first week going to be. After okay. The end of the first week, okay. The second week, okay. Yeah, the second so, week.
One minute. You said that installation. So, mm-hmm. So do we need to install on our local machine, and do you give any server access for couple of months or something? How does it
no, Informatica is not a very big tool. It will take around 10 to 15 GB of your space and 8 GB of RAM. So somebody from Texan IT would log on to your system, install Informatica Power Center. Hopefully it's Windows system that you have, because if it's a Mac system, then it's you'll have to borrow a Windows system, because Informatica clients are installed on Windows system. Those server is installed on both Linux, Unix and Windows. Informatica clients are only installed on Windows. So they'll install it on your system. The only requirement is that you should have at least 8 GB of RAM and 15 to 20 GB of free space. Even after the course is over, you'll have access to the tool. It's not that you'll have access for only 2 months or 3 months.
Okay.
Right. So once that is done, what we'll do is we'll talk about Informatica architecture in detail. The version that I am working on, or the version that I have installed on my system, is 9.1, and the version which is currently out there in the market is 9.5. The 9.6 is rolled out. There are hardly any corporations which have updated to 9.6, but believe me, any version above 8.6 is good enough for you to understand Informatica Power Center, because from a UI perspective, from usage perspective, there are not many differences in Informatica Power Center from 8.6 onwards. So there are few features here and there which have changed, but we can talk about those features when we go about in the course. But the version which will be there on my system will be 9.1, because I had installed it almost a couple of years back. The version which will be there on your system is going to be 9.5. Not many differences from Power Center, that is ETL perspective. There are other tools from Informatica Corporations like MDM and IDQ is where there have been a lot of changes, but Power Center hasn't changed. So we'll understand the architecture of Informatica Power Center in detail and all the client components that you would use to develop a mapping. So the four client components are Designer, Workflow Manager, Workflow Monitor, and a Repository Manager. These are the client components that Informatica Power Center Corporation provides you, and these are the tools on which you will be working on if you are working as a developer. developer. So this course is intended only for somebody who is like who is trying to get into a developer posting. If you are trying to get into an administrative job, this is not the course for you. Administrative, we will not be discussing any of the topics that an administrator would need on a production floor. In this course, we'll only be talking about a developer. Okay. Now after that, we'll talk about the different components of Informatica Part Center. We'll talk about the basics. In the second half of the second week and the early half of the third week, we will try to create mappings which will load the data from one database to the other database, load the data from flat files to database and database to flat files. By understanding these three types of mappings or three or four types of mappings or objects, we'll try to understand all the steps that are required to create a mapping, create a workflow, create a session, load it from one database to the other database, load it from a flat file to a database and vice versa. Now here we'll try to our main focus would be to understand all the different steps that are required to load data from one place or one database to the other database. And the database that I'm using on my system is Oracle database. So in case you want to load data from some other database, you'll have to get the database installed on your system. Just give me a second. I'll be back in a minute with somebody knocking the door. Just give me a second. Okay, so once we understand the basic concepts of how to create a mapping and all, then we'll get into the details of Informatica transformations. Informatica PowerCenter or any other tool, any other ETL tool, it's all about understanding the transformations that the corresponding tool provides. So we'll be looking at these 15 transformations in detail. When I say in detail, we'll talk about all the properties present in each transformation. What would happen if you check some button? What would happen if you uncheck some button? How is data going to be transferred if you configure a few properties one way, if you remove those configurations? So all these 15 transformations that I have listed out in here, we'll try to understand them in detail. And the way I usually teach each transformation is I'll talk about a production-like problem every day whenever I'm talking about a transformation, and then we'll try to solutionize it using the transformation that we are talking about that day. And there are a few transformations which have a lot of properties, a lot of configurations need to be done, let's say expression transformation or a lookup transformation, which would take at least a couple of days. In case of lookup, will take at least 4 or 5 days to understand all the properties of a lookup transformation. So in case a transformation has a lot of properties, we'll try to cover them in 2 days or 3 day sessions. In case the transformation has limited properties like filter transformation, router transformation, we'll try to cover them in a day. I'll not teach more than one transformation in a day because I make sure that students or whoever is attending the session have enough ample time, or they have good amount of time to work on the transformation and get back to me if they have any questions. So we'll talk about one transformation per day in case that's in smaller transformation. In case you have a lot of configurations to be done, we'll talk about the transformations for 2 days or 3 days. We'll talk about all these 15 transformations, and I would use one of the schemas that Oracle provides, let's say HR schema or OE schema or PM schema. At the same time, I already have created a third normal database on which I have created a lot of examples on that, so we'll be using one of them. After this, these are the advanced topics. I really hate to categorize topics into advanced and basics, but if you talk about these advanced topics, I'll be talking about all these advanced topics for sure, and I'll also cover few of the other topics which might not have been listed in here. So when we talk about each transformation in detail, we'll try to cover all these topics that I have listed out in the advanced concepts also, right? So let's say I'm talking about Informatica lookup transformation, then we'll talk about different types of caches. So I have put them into an advanced topics, but these are something which will which we'll try to understand when we talk about the transformation itself. Now, once we are done with this, we'll talk about the case study in detail. The case study is all about creating a data warehouse, creating dimensions, type 1, type 2, type 3, and understand how do you load these dimensions, how do you create these dimensions using all the transformations that we have learned so far. And we'll try to load three types of facts. One is a transactional fact, aggregate fact, and a snapshot fact. This is how we would end the entire course. During the course, I would upload all the videos that we are, say we are having a session on Informatica parse and filter transformation. Then I'll upload that video recording or the session recording on the Google Drive, and I'll share that across to everybody so that they'll have access to that session during the course of time and even after the course is over. At the same time, I have a lot of material which I have accumulated over a period of time. So I'll upload all those materials on the Google Drive where you can access them. The code that we are going to see in the course, what I'll do is that I'll export them and I'll upload them on the Google Drive. All you can do is you can import the code and you can see this. You can go through the code that we are going through in the sessions. But what I encourage people are who are trying to learn this tool, instead of using the code that I have already written, I encourage them to write their own Informatica code or Informatica mapping so that they'll try to understand, they'll have some hands-on experience. So this is about the course, and the course is going to be in the morning sessions. It will be from 7:30 in the morning to 8:30. That's IST timings that I'm talking about, 7:30 IST to 8:30 IST daily from Monday to Friday, 5 days in a week. And the course would last anywhere from 30 sessions to 35 sessions. So this is how the entire course is structured. You have any questions, Shravan, let me know. This is the details of the course that we're going to, that I'm going to teach in this Informatica Power Center course.
Yeah, I have questions.
Yeah, like, go ahead.
So you said that you need only 15 GB. How about you need, where you load, I mean, database, from where we get the database?
Oh, database also will be created on your system. So you need not worry about that. The way Informatica installation is done is that Informatica installation or Informatica is stored in relational database. So you will create a different database for Informatica itself where Informatica will be stored. Apart from that, we'll create a couple of more databases or couple of more schemas. One of the schema will be used as a source, one of the schema will be used as target.
So that's how it's going to be. VM or just directly on the
system? It would depend on you. In case you are okay with a VM, folks from Texanity would install or give you a VM which you can copy on your system. I encourage people to use a VM because there is no installation required for that. At the same time, it's not going to use a lot of resources of your system in case the VM is off.
But I already have one VM in my system.
So you need to shut down that VM and switch on this VM. So I don't think so. VM is all about a file, right? And
yeah.
And launch a file. So I don't think so that's going to create any issues.
Okay.
That's it. Don't worry about installation. Installation will be taken care of and you'll have access throughout the course and even after the course, maybe using a VM or maybe direct installation done on your system. That is something which I would say you need not worry about. In case you have any questions about the course content, about the topics that we are going to talk, you know, you can ask me these questions right away. Regarding the VM and all, I think folks from Texan IT will help you on that.
Okay, and also, so you will give the recordings for all the 30 classes, or you will give recording only for few topics?
No. The recordings will, okay. If I can show you the recordings, just give me a second. Okay. Okay, I'll share the recordings for all the classes. So these are the three batch recordings that I have loaded on this drive. So let's, if I talk about this recording which I have recently finished, this is the batch that I have recently finished. So all the recordings will be here. So you see all these recordings will be present in here. So you can access all these recordings. So I don't think so you need to worry. At the same time, I'll have a material also. So in case you have training material, I'll upload all the training material, all the slides that I'm using throughout this course. So I don't think so you need to worry about the recordings. Recordings are something which are already there. To look at this, so this is an ongoing batch currently. So I have done almost what 13 sessions in here. So you have video recordings for all the 13 sessions, and I'll upload them on the Google Drive.
Okay.
So you said that you have been working on BI technology, right?
Not
what BI and
I've been working on the Siebel CRM for the last 8 years, and as part of that, as part of marketing campaigns and other stuff, we have to get the data, segmented data from OBAE.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
And the same, I mean, the same subject areas can be used for reporting purpose also. So I only know the front end things, but I don't know how the back end thing, how the path and dimensions will be created and how the data is. I know only from the available things I can get use of those tables and columns and the presentation there and get those things. And
okay, so you have worked on the RPD as well in the business layer and in the presentation layer, or it's just that?
I did not create any RPD and other stuff, but I know the RPD functionality and other stuff.
Okay, great. I understand that. Now what you want to know is that how data comes into these facts and dimensions,
right,
and
right.
Then how it comes into the RPD and how do you use it. That's what you want
right.
to know.
Right.
So
you will not be teaching about data warehousing, right? You will be talking about only the data coming from OLTP to OLAP only.
Yes, I'll talk about how you bring the data from OLTP to OLAP. At the same time, when you bring it to OLAP, it's nothing but the data warehouse. What we'll try to understand is that what is a, from an ETL perspective, we'll try to understand all these transformations. How do you transform the data from an ERP system or an OLTP system to an OLAP system? That's what we'll try to understand. How do you denormalize the data? What are the different transformations that are there inside Informatica if you're working as a developer? In case you want to backtrack, see how the data is coming, and if you're using an Informatica Parse Center tool, how do you, you know, backtrack all those things? Or something that from an ETL perspective is what we'll try to understand throughout this course.
Okay, so what? How is the market for Informatica?
Well, market is not bad, I would say. Market is pretty good, and there are a lot of folks. See, basically there are three kinds of folks that I see getting trained on Informatica. The first genre is people who are trying to switch a technology. Somebody is working in mainframe, somebody is working in some other technology, because there's good market for Informatica, ETL tools specifically. So they try to learn Informatica Power Center. Why they'll try to learn Informatica Power Center when there are other ETL tools present in the market? Because Informatica has been there in the market for almost 15 years now, and there are a lot of clients who use Informatica Power Center. Though there are other tools like DataStage and BODS, they come next to Informatica in terms of the number of clients, the number of job openings and all. So I would rate Informatica Power Center and DataStage almost on par, but I would give a bit of edge. The Informatica Power Center has a bit of edge on DataStage because it's an easy to use tool, and there are a lot of clients who use Informatica Power Center when compared to DataStage. There are the other set of folks are people who are trying to, who have just finished their MS and trying to, you know, get a job. I know how it works. I know, I'm pretty sure that you'd know how it works for somebody who's just finished their MS in US. So they put some fake experience and they try to get the job, right? So so they try to get into Informatica Power Center because the openings are good. The number, you'd get at least one or two calls per week for sure if you're based out of US. If you're based out of Canada and UK, I would say you'd get at least one or two calls in a month. That's how the market is in these countries, because I've been training people and at the same time I have been giving fake interviews as well. So this is how the market is. And the third set of folks are the audience are somebody who has come to a, who did fly to US as a dependent. They have gotten H-1B and they're trying to, you know, get into IT. So these three sets of audience, they try to get into technology, and the, at least the next, the last two set of audience, they try to get into technology, which not very difficult to understand, not very difficult to use. At the same time, there are good openings. The first set of audience are somebody who are already into IT, who can pick up technology very fast. But, you know, Informatica PowerCenter is not a very difficult tool. It has good GUI. It, at the same time, currently the openings are decent, based out of India, based out of US. So I don't think so that should be a problem.
Okay. And how about the support in terms of post training?
Okay, so support in terms of post training is something which I can get you in touch with few folks. I used to do the support work after the post training, but right now I'm kind of busy only in trainings. If you have already got into an Informatica project, you are trying to understand it, we can talk about that separately after the course. I used to do it. I have few more friends who are still doing that. So we can talk about the support, you know, once you have gotten to training and all that. So that should not be a problem. I can get you in touch with somebody who can give you support. But I used to do the support in the past, but right now, because I'm busy with all these training batches and all, and to be frank, I'm earning good when compared to the support, so I'm not right now.
Okay. And okay. And the videos which I saw on the YouTube and from there which I got this number, are you the same person or different person?
I am not very sure what videos you have seen.
Looking into the added advantage rather than
make sure that there are few folks who say that who will say that after the course I'll become a master of this tool. No, you're not going to become master of this tool, but you'll have enough ammunition with you so that you can explore the tool. At the same time, I'll provide you enough course content, course material, so that you can go through that, sit in an interview and crack the interview.